Hello there, everyone, and welcome here to the Charlotte Roval for the Mountain Dew KickStart Cup Series race. Here, this is the first time these Cup drivers will be here at the Roval, and it's the first time NORLA has ever come to the Roval, so it should be a pretty interesting race to watch. So, sitting on your front row is going to be the 22 of Cody Goforth capturing the pole, and to his outside of Fado Ford, at 17 of Marcus Sacchi. Behind those guys, you have Jeff Bryden at 24. And affiliate teammate 95 of James Bowles. Jeff Bryce still looking for that first win on the season. Bowles trying to go for win number two. 38 of Tyler Markell starts in a really good position to try and win this thing. Then you have Sam and Oskin. You have the 74 of Mitchell Collins. And the 34 of Zachary Fitzwater Sr. Then you have the 18 of William Brock and Andy Fowl to his outside. Here's the rest of your starting lineup from 11th on back. So coming into this race, after this race, this is the final race of the regular season. Whoever is in a points lead after this race will be the regular. Well, basically, William Brock already has a regular season championship locked in, so he's really far ahead in the standings as far as being first. So William Brock coming into this race is the regular season champion. Let's get you down to the commands.
Drivers, start your engines.
And the engines have been fired up here. So again, William Brock, he scores the regular season championship. And after this race, it'll finally be time to go on the road to try to crown Cup champion here. As next round, we head to Chicagoland for the start of the playoffs. 16 drivers will get a shot, but only of course, only one will be able to become a champion. Cody Goforth, most wins this season. I believe he ties along with the 9 of Sam and Oskins for the most wins, 3 each. Oskin after winning Darlington. Marcus Sacchi, no wins this season. He could still try and get a win along with a 24. No one else can make the playoffs. The field is already set, but here we go. Cody Goforth is going to lead it to the green here at the Roval. Apologize about the little lag here, as this track has a lot of things to it here. Oh, Carhartt into the wall in the back.
Racket behind us.
Up and over, I believe that was a 47, I think. Oh no, Nick Smith. And the 2 of Dylan Ebrahimian, I think that's who that was. Now frame rates are dying here, but a really big crash early on here at the Roval. Let's see what happened. Dylan Ebrahimian looks like he got into the wall right there in the first corner. Oh, and then came down to clip Nick Smith. Oh, man. Oh, Jesus Christ. Up and over the safer barrier wall right there. Actually, I think that's a concrete wall. Another look at it here. Yeah, it looks like Ebrahimian just turned down into the 4. I don't think he knew it was 3 wide. And then right into the 20 of Max Anderson. I believe the 41 also gets collected. That's such a strange wreck right there. Glitched into the wall and up and over the 2. Holy cow. Alexander Rowan, 11, also getting collected, but tough break for Nick Smith. Not what he wanted here. Oh, and the 47. Yeah, the 47 as well. Let's see what happened. Oh, he clips a wall and clips the Bank of America wall right there, and Nicholas Wade just ran right into him. It looks like he too glitched into the wall, and he's going to be out of the running of the Charlotte Roval race here. Tough break for Nick Smith and all those other guys. Not what they wanted to see. Some side-by-side racing here. This is a trouble spot in practice. See right there, Sammy Davis getting into the wall just a little bit. Head back up to the front. Side-by-side battle right here for third. Going to be Sam and Oskin in the 9 getting that position from James Bowles. Here we go, battle for the race lead. Got the 17 of Marcus Sacchi now. Trying to go underneath Cody Goforth, who has some damage to the right side of his car. And a Goforth into the wall again. Marcus Sacchi right now really forcing the issue on Goforth. He drives it really wide. Got to be careful in that corner right there. It's sort of side by side with Jeff Bright for position. These two are just going at it for the race lead right now. Neither driver giving an inch. Let's go forth and Marcus Sacchi. Go forth trying to get his 4th win on the season. He's going to get into the wall just a little bit along with a couple other drivers right there. How about Tyler Markell having a good run? Zachary Fitzwater Sr. still trying to get by the 24. Looks like most everyone else is single file up here. Battle right here, Jose Mills and Shane Wentz off in the 7. More drivers seem to be getting into that wall right there in that corner. Got a feel for those guys who are out on, in that first corner, especially Nick Smith, playoff contender, not what you want heading into the playoffs. It's right rear. In the 22.
Clear all around, all clear. Step 4, we're going to do what we talked about here and adjust air pressure.
COVID, Gordon Guilforth able to clear and get away from Marcus Sacchi, who got into the wall right there. Now he's on a fire from Sam and Oskin in the 9. Sachi's trying to fend off Oskin, who's looking to get 2 in a row here, looking for his 4th win of the season. And drivers going on pit road. Capoel Abai and got the. See what happened here. Who going into those S's right there, the bus stop, and just Nicholas Wade lost grip on the car right there and couldn't be able to save it. And the 3 of Eric Monaco also go around. Dallas Carpentier, Tim Randolph. Oh, and right there, Capoel Abai ran into the 60. Got a 16 of German Ickel as well. And the 02, Alex McClary gets collected as well. So, tough break. Oh, Carhartt into the wall. Who was that? That was James Bowles and it looks like Tyler Markell. Oh, man. See what happened here. Oh man, looks like Bowles or Markell and Bowles just made contact. And pretty hard hit right, yep. And this is another incident. Tyler Markell's hard into the inside or up to the outside wall right there. Got dumped right there by the 74 of Mitchell Collins. And now Markell is out of the race. And remember, yellow flags are turned off for the road courses as always. For those of you who are wondering where the yellow is. But out front still, the 22 of Cody Goforth, 17 of Marcus Sacchi still running second. Sam Oskin currently running third right there. Goforth, he's been really quiet as of late, but during interviews he said he's just saving his stuff here until his playoff time. And this is the final regular season race, so Goforth back, he's getting back to, trying to get back to his winning ways. Side by side right here is Marcus Yepes and Jeff McReynolds. Battle for position, got Eddie Raleigh right there in the 32. And if we didn't get 16 different winners already this season, that 32 probably would have made the playoffs because he's 9th in points coming into this race, I believe, 8th or 9th. And the 8 got into the wall just a bit right there. Keep an eye on these guys through the S's. They're able to make it through that time by. Oh, heavy damage for William Brock in the 18. Your points leader and regular season champion as he's trying to get down pit road, but the 48 is right there. He's going to get down pit road just fine. And what is this? Oh, this is what happened. Mitchell Collins made contact with someone and went around right in front of William Brock, who couldn't slow it down in time and destroyed the 18 of Brock. And Mitchell Collins now with heavy damage. Collins was running, I believe, just outside of the top 10, if not inside of top 10. There's Joe Jefferson. As they're coming up on lap cars. Or no, they're not lap cars. What happened to the 22? What happened to the 22, Cody Goforth? Oh, he gets turned by Marcus Sacchi. And then hits that inside of wall and came right back up in front of the 17. Very unfortunate for Cody Goforth. Again, having a bad race. And that's probably going to take him out of chance of getting the win here at the Charlotte Roval. Oh man, that's not going to be a happy Cody Goforth right there.
Marcus
Sacchi going down pit road. So that's going to hand the lead over to Sam and Oskin in the 9. And Fitzwater now up to 2nd. James Bowles 3rd. And 4th is going to be the 24. Jeff Bright. You also have Jay Jefferson running in the 5th position. Goforth 6th last time by at the line. To be listening.
We are the best car out there for 100 laps every week. Track rubber in, we go to junk. I can't tell you what to do. Broken record. Just love how we never even get the race at the end of these races. Just like we get flung like a burger.
Goforth obviously not happy over the radio right there. With Marcus Sacchi in the 17. Side by side right here, Eddie Riley and Alexander Rowe. These guys are back in the mid-pack here. Up at Toyota's, Marcus Yepez again getting into that inside wall. He has destroyed the right side of that car. Meanwhile, these two battling side by side. Riley has just been really consistent all season long. Top 10 in the points. Contact right here and around goes Nathan Ramon. In the 37 and 56 as well. Oh, and the 3 of Monaco again. But they're able to keep going right there. Allow for Marcus Yepez and others to catch up to them. Here's Cody Goforth right there. Just got passed, looks like, by the 21 of Trevor Collins, but still out front. It's a 9. How about Fitzwater currently running in second, trying to hunt down the 9 of Sam Adoskin. He's going for 2 in a row. Bowles having a really good run. Garcia's up here as well. Mitchell Collins, he rounds out the top 10. He's trying to hold off Eli Bright for that position. Shot on board, Cody Goforth here, and listen in.
This is bad. I didn't feel like I was running hard. We're racing. We're slow. We're just racing. And now the right rear feels like... And they keep trying to work turn 2, like vacuuming. It's dirty as hell.
So Goforth struggling with his car here ever since that incident with Marcus Sacchi, and it's going to be really frustrating for the driver. How about Juan Garcia in the top 10 right now, having a pretty decent run as he run behind those guys. Still out front is the 9 of Sam Adoskin. Right now Fitzwater just trying to get there. They have lap cars ahead. They have about 3.5 laps to go. There's Marcus Sacchi with heavy hood damages. Looks like he took the hood off that 17. He had to come down pit road. 32 of Eddie Riley trying to get by Eric Monaco into 3. Battle right here. Shane Wenzloff all over the back bumper of Jose Mills. Mills, who won out at Kentucky to get himself into playoffs, along with his teammate who won Indianapolis. That was Owen Finley, who's out of this race right now. Malik Nevins going by Eli Bright. Some strong competition right there. Still side by side. That's the thing about this oval. Oh man, and into the wall. Nevins got into the wall pretty good right there, and that's gonna allow Eli Bright to get right by him. There's Cody Goforth just having such a rough day. Here's the 9 of Sam Adoskin right now.
I picked up a bad vibration. Just got a nurse and it won't turn at all. It's got a bad vibration under braking and a real bad push.
Oh, that is not good.
Look at all the gauges right now.
That is not good for Sam Adoskin.
Get on that left rear if you got to. Do whatever you got to do, man. Keep digging now. Go get him.
Sam Adoskin complaining about a vibration on his car and being the leader. That is not good with a couple of laps to go. This time by will be 2 laps to go. So Sam Adoskin having a vibration in his ride, he's saying, and you're going to have to keep an eye on that. Mitchell Collins trying to go underneath Garcia 4 position right there. Nevin still trying to get by that 88 of Eli Bright. Remember, he got into the wall earlier, and that allowed Eli Bright to go for the pass. So, next round. As I mentioned before, it's going to be a big weekend out at Chicagoland. All 4 series will be there, including IndyCars, Trucks, National, and of course, Cup Series. So, pretty big weekend out at Chicagoland. Let's try on board Fitzwater here and listen in.
Just be smooth, be smart, we'll get by him.
Fitzwater trying to hunt down the 9 right there. Sam Adoskin gets a really good run right here in that final few corners.
Right there, 2 to go.
At the line, 2 to go.
Keep digging here, dig down, you got it.
As he has lap cars to deal with along with Sam Adoskin. Can pull that by right there. Great friend of Adoskin. He's going to get out the way. And he's probably going to block right there because the 12 drives for Sam Adoskin. That is Adoskin Motorsports. And now what the 12 can do is try to hold back Fitzwater right there and help your boss win. Even though Adoskin drives for another team, he owns that 12 team. pit order, not having it. He's going to try and get the 12 out of the way, and he does. He's hunting down that 9 off Samet Oskin. And into the wall right there, Jeremy Icklin, the 16. And Oskin got into the wall right there as well. The 34 made contact with Oskin. Oh no, that's really bad for Fitzwater, and he's going to lose a ton of grounds on the 9. And now he's under fire from James Bowles in the 95. Tough break for Fitzwater. Ran right, oh, and James Bowles, he gets into the wall now. It's going to allow for the 24 of Jeff Bryan and the 14 of Joe Jefferson to get by, but Samet Oskin coming to the white flag, trying to get the 16 of Ickle out of the way. One more time here at the Charlotte Roval for Samet Oskin in the 9, trying to go back-to-back here. And Fitzwater, he's got to be angry right there. 16 got into the wall. The 9 tried to get away right there, and then he got into the wall as well. And Fitzwater trying to dive it in there. He gets into Samet Oskin, and now lost. That probably just cost him the race right there. Lost a ton of grounds on Samet Oskin, who's still behind Jeremy Icklin, the 16, and it's probably going to be a penalty on that 16. It's going to be a 50-point penalty on Jeremy Icklin. He's kind of holding up the race leader right now, and Icklin gets into the wall. Oh no, and Samet Oskin with heavy. Oh man, Samet Oskin with heavy hood damage. Can he make it all the way back? Samet Oskin, can he even see out that thing? And now here comes Fitzwater diving underneath the 12 again. Samet Oskin with heavy hood damage. I don't know if he can make it all the way. And he is leaking oil all over the racetrack. Samet Oskin is going to come down pit road. And the 34 of Zachary Fitzwater Sr. with the last lap pass, he's going to win it at the Roval. Oh my goodness, what a finish. Samet Oskin pitted, coming to the checkers. Wow, I have never...
I can't believe it, man. What a day. We break the back of that duck, man. We're away. Woo! Great job, guys.
Wow. That is... Oh my goodness, I've never seen that. Samet Oskin pitted, coming to the checkers, and gave the win to Zachary Fitzwater Sr. and Jeff Bright, P2. James Bowles looked like he got third right there. Joe Jefferson fourth, and Trevor Conley is going to get fifth. But man, what a turn of events right there. As Zachary Fitzwater Sr. going to capture his third win on the season. And he's going to go into the playoffs. I believe the points leader, because the points will reset. But how about that for Zachary Fitzwater Sr.? It looks like Samet Oskin ended up 10th. As I've already mentioned, the top five. Cody Goforth still came home P6. Juan Garcia 7th. Eli Bright 8th. And Mitchell Collins 9th. And then there's Oskin in the 10th position. You really got a feel for that team of Samet Oskin. He is not going to be happy with the 16. Ibrahimi and Nick Smith both finished 42nd and 41st. Max Anderson, Markel, William Brock, and Diego Epez, they all did not finish the race. Capuel Abay and Owen Finley, the only drivers a lap down. And then the rest of the 34 drivers finished on the lead lap. So, Zachary Fitzwater Sr., captures, I believe, his 10th career win. And he's going to burn it down for the crowd here. Fitzwater, who we all know, is really good on these road courses. But after he made contact with the 9 of Samet Oskin, I thought it was over for the 34. And then Oskin got into some trouble with the lap car. Couldn't see as the hood was lifted up. And then there was oil and fluids leaking all over the track, and with the NORLA rules, you cannot stay on track if your car is leaking fuel fluid for other drivers' safety. Samet Oskin was so close to getting two straight victories, but he's going to have to wait. So that's going to do it for the regular season. Congratulations to Zachary Fitzwater Sr. on his 10th career Mountain Dew Kickstart Cup Series win. And he's going to head into the playoffs really strong here. Next week, we head to Chicagoland for a big race weekend. All four series will be there. The IndyCar Series finale will be at Chicagoland. Then you have the Trucks, the National, and of course the start of the playoffs for the Cup Series at Chicagoland as well. Until then, we'll see you guys for the next race. Congratulations to Fitzwater on the win. Here's your standings and the playoff standings after the round of 26.